a screen with a lot of different languages.
Yes.
I don't speak French.
Yes, it was bad. But we figured it out just for you guys. We wanted to do a good stream.
Yeah, we just pushed the power button again.
Yeah.
Right. But we held it down first.
Yeah, yeah.
It was pretty silly.
Yeah. It shuts down.
We're good now, though. We're live now, so it's all good.
Yeah.
We're good. So, yeah, guys, welcome to the Weekly Galaxy, our Thursday 6:30 p.m. show that we've been doing the last few weeks.
Yeah.
And we're going to continue. Episode four.
Four.
Wow. Your third episode.
Yeah, this is your third episode because you were Hollywood last week.
last week, Ramon decided not to join us. And that's fine. You know, life calls. Sometimes you got other things to do.
I was in the episode.
Yeah.
For like 2 minutes, you saw my face
that's
on
fair.
This episode.
All right. All right. Your fourth episode then. And we have a guest this week, as you guys can tell. This is Sam. Sam's an artist here at the studio. Do you want to tell us a little about yourself?
Yeah. So I've been with Iron Galaxy for a couple months now. I'm a UI artist at the company. I've been in the game industry for 6 years, and I love every minute of it. So
all right. Awesome. Well, welcome to the stream. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Yeah. Excellent. So what are we doing today, Tom?
Today we're playing 7 Days to Die.
Okay.
Which, if you aren't familiar with 7 Days to Die, zombie hoarding, crafting, survival game.
Yes.
You sort of live through the days, or you're trying to, you know, create stuff, get ready for the nights. The nights, zombies come out, but on the seventh night, a really big zombie horde comes out, and it's very terrifying.
Right.
So we were going to start a fresh world. Me and Ramon were going to do multiplayer and sort of give you guys an idea of what the game's like. Yeah, so that's that.
Cool.
So we'll start up a world right now.
All
right. Yeah. If you're afraid of zombies... beware.
Yeah, keep your lights on.
Yeah, there are a lot of zombies, and there's a lot of zombie sounds.
Right.
I've been playing this alone late at night before and gotten legitimately scared.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's definitely something to keep in mind. If
yeah. I have recurring zombie nightmares.
Yeah.
It's really bad.
So before we go, you've played this game a bit.
Yes.
I've played on PC. I've never played on console before.
Okay.
So we are playing this on console. We're using two PS4s.
Yeah.
To do this. You have never played this game.
I have never actually physically played it, no. Mm-hmm. But I've watched it numerous times.
All right.
Yeah.
And Sam?
Same here.
So you've seen it?
I've watched it numerous times. I know about it. Just have not officially played
it. All right. Well, you're going to see it from the beginning, then. So let me continue this game. We started up a little bit here before.
Yeah, we found each other. We didn't want to spend
early
part of the stream.
We'll be next to each other. So I'm going to jump in this world now, and then I'm going to invite... Ramon to be my friend in the game, which is great.
I love inviting Ramon to be my friend.
Yeah. So then we become allies in the game, and then we're sort of working together in this zombie land to sort of survive. It's a lot easier with a partner. Mm. When you got zombies beating you up, it's a little bit easier when you have someone else to help you.
Drink go.
What was your drink, Ramon?
Right here?
One of those.
There
that
you go.
That one's mine.
Oh.
Don't take my IPA.
Oh, I don't know. Ramon?
Oh, did you pop that open from here?
Here you go.
You did steal my drink.
I did steal yours.
There you go, Ramon. Sorry about that.
All right, so.
7 Days to Die. We're in here. Oh, there I am. All right, so first things first.
So you're in like a desert area right now.
Yeah, so okay. I'm going to go. Oh, let's see. Oh, he's offline.
Yeah,
okay.
You have to invite me.
So I'm going to invite.
I was going to say something really dumb. I'm like, how am I online right now?
You're here. All right. So I just invited Ramon, so hopefully he can come join me in a minute.
Oh, yeah. I got to put on this headphone.
We have like. So I'm here in this.
I should put up your game volume.
I'm here in this world. You can sort of get an idea of the map. Here's what I've explored so far, just a little bit. But it's a really massive, massive map.
Yeah.
So I guess. All right, so since I'm new to this game,
yes.
Right.
I don't really know too much about it outside of watching people die.
Yeah, that's definitely a part of it.
Yeah.
Or getting attacked.
Yeah, so can you just give like a brief introduction to like you first start the game, what do you expect?
Yeah, so as you can tell at the top of the screen here right by the compass, we're on day two right now, and it's sort of counting up.
Okay.
So it's 5:30 in the morning on day two.
Yeah, we haven't really played anything.
We haven't played through, yeah, we just basically booted up the first day so we can meet up with each other. So
yeah.
Now we're together. Well,
okay, so when you guys meet up for the... when you guys start your session,
yeah.
You guys are in different areas of the map.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay.
So it looks like...
Yeah, so this is us.
It looks like there's my pal.
I'm the cowboy hat.
There's cowboy hat there. So right now, we sort of need to gather up some resources so we can start crafting.
Right.
So I need to get some of these plants. I need to... Let's see what I got here. So I can come in here. And this is sort of the categories for the things that you can craft. So I need to get a tool. I need to get a stone axe. So what do I need when this with the stone axe? So it sort of gives you the recipe right here for what you need. So you need wood, you need plant, you need stone. So I've got the wood and the plant, so I need to find...
Yeah, and they have kind of like a help you through the first parts of the game over on the
Right. And I need to get I need to get Ramon to be tracking on here. I need to be able to see him. So now he's on my compass, so I can find him wherever I go. So now I need to find some rocks. Do you see any rocks around here? So I guess. There's one. I think I need two to get my stone axe. Yeah, so now I can go in here. So now this is no longer dimmed out, and I can sort of craft.
Nice.
So down here, it sort of starts creating that.
So do these things that you're crafting, do they break over time?
Yes. Yep. Okay. So as you use them, they break down. All right. And the more that you craft them, the stronger they become.
Okay.
So right now in the lower left, you can see our stone axe, and it's a one right now. But now that I have this, I can start mining a little bit more. So now I'm getting more rock. And you can see what I'm getting here on the right. I'm getting iron, and I'm getting some rock here. So for the first part of the game, you're sort of grinding, trying to get your stuff.
I see.
We also probably both need to get some sort of weapon in case a zombie pops up. Yep. So luckily, there's a whole weapon category.
So can zombies pop out at any point in time, or is there a specific time of day?
So at night, they're going to come out more.
Okay.
But they'll come out.
They're also more powerful at night.
Yep. So I need...
Yeah, they kind of roam around, so... I'm pretty sure they spawn too, but they're always roaming. So when you're traveling through the world, you'll run across them.
So here's a little bit of wood that I can get because I need to make a stone club. A wooden club, I mean. So now I got this wooden club. Craft it. So now if a zombie pops up, I can start swinging him with this. So I think now that we've each got... Ramon, you've got some sort of weapon, right?
Yeah.
Just in case. So I think now we should go do a little bit of exploring.
All right, cool.
So just follow me. I think there's a town somewhere around here.
Take
a look at my map.
So you have a jar in your hand.
Yeah, I was going to say, what is that?
So that's my water.
Okay.
I'm just sort of walking around with it.
Yeah, there's certain... you have, some vital elements you got to keep up. It's like a food, hunger. Mm. There's thirst. You can actually, if you bring up... If we bring up your menu, you can see where you're at. Where's the other characters? Yeah, so over on the right, you can see that he has, I can't read,
60 food, 60 water. Right. Yeah.
Okay.
And it'll warn you as you start getting a little bit lower.
Can you eat people?
You cannot eat. Well, you could. So if you killed a zombie and got some flesh, maybe you could cook. No, I'm just there's animals though. There's animals though that. That's another thing we should do is we should probably craft some bows.
Okay.
Right.
So if there's a situation where it's just you and Ramon, you got no food, you can't just eat Ramon.
No.
Okay.
No.
Because I would totally eat.
No, especially since we're allies.
Yeah. I think friendly fire.
So this sort of stuff is all over the map. You got a little spoiled trash here, and you can just sort of loot it. There was nothing in that though. We can try this pile right here. Looks like there was a moldy an old sandwich in here, so I'm probably not gonna take that.
So can you get sick if you eat?
You can. So you could definitely get sick if you eat the wrong thing. So you should definitely read the description of anything that you're going to consume. So here's a pretty cool, what appears to be some sort of apartment building.
You want to loot this thing?
Yeah, let's go in there for a second and see if there's anything good.
All right.
Uh-oh, I see somebody up here. Oh, no.
What? That's a lot of
people. Oh, wow.
Oh, there's a lot.
Oh,
yeah.
My God. Boy. All right, so I think I'm going to craft a bow.
So, all right, so we're gonna get some weapons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see if I. Oh, I need.
I think they're coming after us.
Oh no.
pretty sure.
I need to collect some wood so I can. And so for bow. So here's a little bird's nest right here.
You loot
a bird's nest.
Forget about this.
You have a bird's nest, you get feathers.
Okay.
Feathers are very needed.
You should move. You should move.
Oh, no. Oh, they're following us. So I need to be a little bit more.
So during the daylight, the zombies are a little more. I mean, they still come after you. But they don't run after you.
As I see one
they run
jogging.
Towards you at nighttime.
Oh yeah, man, there's a lot.
At night they are some form of trouble. Okay. And during the day
so
you can kind of
craft
them.
I'm gonna craft a bow and I'm gonna craft 9 arrows here.
Yeah, hurry up and kill. Oh ow,
run, Ramon.
What am I getting attacked? Oh wow, what did you do?
So what is the field of vision like for the zombies? Can they see you from a really long way?
I just ran into a cactus. Yeah, that'll also hurt you.
They could, but they also you can you can like crouch in this game.
Okay.
And walk slower.
Okay.
So they hear.
I see.
I remember a while back on the PC version, you can like see there was like a symbol that told you like whether they can see you or not.
Mm, okay.
But
I need some more wood to craft.
I think they got rid of that.
Okay, so I'm gonna take a shot at one of these. Oh,
did you even hit it? Right. Did you do anything?
Oh man!
Oh boy, they're mad.
Oh,
hey, you got him.
He might still be alive, or she.
Oh. I'm assuming it matters where you shoot them, right?
Yeah. So if I hit them in the head, it's gonna help. Oh, there we go.
So yeah, pops. There's like a.
Oh man, she just uppercutted you.
She just died. Oh,
she was probably like
Here's
a boxer.
Ramon, Ramon finally decided to come help me.
You had a bow.
So there's like two states to these guys. You can like concuss them, and then there's like an actual dead state.
Okay.
So you have to. It's like something to be aware of. That just because they're down doesn't mean they're dead.
Oh.
I would say that guy's dead.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's done.
So you could run away from them, but if you loot their body, you can sometimes find good stuff on them. So it's definitely worth, if you're able to, killing them.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever looted from a zombie body?
It's tough to say. I find it disturbing how many of them carry around rotten sandwiches. they're carrying
maybe
around...
Maybe they were on a picnic when they died.
Yeah, sometimes they're carrying around a treasure map. Okay. Sometimes they're carrying around currency from their past life. This guy just has a couple of empty cans on him.
Yeah.
We're just killing these.
Oh, I love the audio.
I know, me too. I can imagine playing this at night.
Sound like it.
Yeah. Ow. Oh.
We found a mess load of zombies.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. Oh. I'm assuming you can eventually run away from them and they're out of sight? Or how
does
that work?
So there's a group of them right now, and once they're dead, they should be gone.
I think... there's a lot of, like, modifiers you can, like, set to when you create the servers. And it, like, lets you set how much time you have to be out of view. So that they stop trying.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, what does the transition from day to night look like? Like, how much time are you spending in the day? When does it transition?
So right now we have... Oh, so she... This is really good. She had two bottles of water, which come in handy. Let's see if this one had... So we have it. Oh, and this was some painkillers. Oh,
can you take her shoes?
I just picked up the ham sandwich.
And then, like, throw the shoes at zombies?
Unfortunately, you can't just take whatever they're wearing. It's got to be what they've been carrying on them.
Okay.
So as far as the length of day question, so I have this set for a 24-hour period in the game is 30 minutes. You can have that be as much as an hour. So you could play every day as one full hour of real-life time.
Can you extend that time?
No, the hour's the longest.
Oh, okay.
And that'll give you ample time to sort of prepare a base, because that's by the time we get to the seventh day, you really need to have a base that is going to protect you from a giant horde of zombies. That's a land drop right there, or a little loot drop. So maybe...
Oh, is that what that is?
So did we want to go explore that building finally? What happened?
We got
sidetracked by that little mini horde.
Killed,
where were they?
Zombies.
Yeah, I think it was this over here, right? Oh, yeah, there it is. All right, so we got some zombies, got some good zombie kills. Showed you guys the bow and arrow. Let's see. If I could find a tree, that would be great. I need to get some more wood. Okay, here we go.
Is that the only way you can obtain wood?
Yep, so that's how you get the wood, is by chopping down trees. And we're in sort of a deserty area, as you can tell. In the game, there's four biomes. This one's sort of a deserty area. So this door's locked. So you gotta bust it down.
Oh, you couldn't just open the door from that point?
It's all locked.
Right. I see.
It's locked right now, so we'll get in there. Okay. Okay, we're in. So this is somebody's house that I guess lived here before the zombie.
Detective Tom
got
on
a
case.
Little. Oh, we got some paper.
Oh, yeah.
So we could go in here and we can sort of take a look at what each of these items is that we just found. So we just found this paper. Paper can be used with other ingredients to make shotgun ammo, blunderbuss ammo, TNT, and more. So paper is an ingredient that you need sort of later in the game once you're crafting weapons.
Okay.
And you can click, you know, what is it used in. So these are the things that you use paper for.
Can
so
you burn down these buildings? And
You could just destroy them block by block.
Okay.
You can't really catch them on fire, but there's really no point. And a lot of times you'll find a building like this and say, you know, this would make for a good starter base.
Yeah.
So at night you might hide out in here,
right,
as long as you kill the zombies. So me and Ramon are sort of just exploring in here. You want to sort of loot anything you can find, so these fridges are going to be great.
Yeah, I think.
Oh, more water, perfect.
One of the first things that like I always try and find before, because like you can set up like a base type thing, but a very important item in this game is the pipe. Usually like to, because it's how you can make a furnace, right?
Yep, a forge.
Mm. A forge.
You need lead pipe. And a lead pipe is going to be found in like sinks like this. So there's some
there
lead pipe, right, or some iron pipe, I mean.
Can you also use that iron pipe to like bash people?
Nope, it's
face?
Not a weapon.
Oh.
Okay. That would be cool. There's other like weird objects that can be used as weapons. Hmm. They're just not as strong.
Okay.
Like there's very specific, like this weapons category is really the things you should be using to hurt.
I see.
Hurt zombies.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like you really want to explore everywhere and every crevice.
Yeah, because you can really find good stuff in like this random toilet. Maybe there won't be anything. There's not anything in this toilet. But like you really want it. It rewards you if you're diligent about raiding stuff. So right in here, found some lead and we found a cooking pot. A cooking pot will be useful later when we have a fire going and stuff like that. And we can cook the raw meat that we gather from animals, cook other stuff. Let's see what's out here. So this is a giant apartment building. If we looted this whole thing, it would take a long time.
Yeah.
So this looks like that's just a little patio.
Can you ever max out on your capacity of what you can carry?
Yes, definitely. So once you start a base, one of the main things in your base is storage chests, wooden storage chests, and you'll sort of put stuff in there that you don't need. Because if I pull up my menu here, all those blocks are where we can have items.
Mm.
But once those are filled up, you're done.
Yeah.
And you can have 1,000 of each of those. Well, certain ones you can have 1,000 of. But there's a capacity for everything, yes.
Okay.
Are
these chests like magical chests where you put it in one area and it's actually in the other?
No, it's just a wooden chest.
Oh, okay.
It's just like something that you would, you know, have at your house under your bed where you store a bunch of crap.
Okay.
So I think you guys kind of get the idea of looting an apartment building. Oh, my God. I keep running into cactuses. That's the problem with the desert. The one nice thing about the desert, though, is you can mine this cactus you'll get a little bit of fruit. Yeah.
All right. Nice.
So you get this yucca fruit,
nice.
And you can take that. Let's see. Take that and eat it. So I'm eating that. Gain a little bit of stamina, a little bit of fullness.
Okay.
So the desert can provide you with some food, which is nice. More trash. Oh, what do we have here? Candy and tin. Candy tin can. Grandma's candy tin, good for scrapping or perfect casing for a yummy home cooked landmine. So later in the game,
okay.
we might cook a land or make a landmine for our base. We have some oil here, crafting repair kits. So really, you're just trying to find as much crap as you can.
So honestly, I don't feel as bad like throwing stuff in the trash now.
Yeah,
you know, if there's leftovers.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if there's a zombie apocalypse, I can always come back.
Right.
To
right,
it.
Exactly.
Like, thank God I did not finish this bottle of water.
Oh, especially when there's like.
What's Ramon doing over here?
He's just standing there. He's
okay.
Just chilling.
Yeah, trash.
he's looking at the car. He wants to hotwire it.
I wish we could just hotwire this. And,
yeah.
This is good. Iron pickaxe.
Oh, I thought you were... I was looking at Ramon's screen. I was like, that's a dead guy.
So an iron pickaxe is something that if you were to craft that, would take a long time to get all the materials needed.
Right.
So to just find that in a car is very useful.
Mm.
So this sort of takes the place of the stone axe as far as a mining thing. So this hits rocks way better.
Okay.
So it's taking it down a lot more than a stone axe would. A stone axe would probably take twice as long to get rid of to get this rock mined down. I see a zombie coming up over here.
Mm.
So we're getting kind of close to the nighttime. You can see it's 1600. Ramon, do you think we should go explore? Do you think we should stay here for the night? What do you think we should
do? We should probably explore a little bit.
Maybe we should go towards that loot box in the distance.
Yeah.
Let's see how far that is. It's not too far. It's right. Let's see. Right there.
It's a little far. Yeah.
We'll get out.
Let's go.
There. Let's
kill
get
some
out
zombies
there.
On the way.
Go on an adventure.
Yeah. I need to find some wood so I can make some more arrows and some more feathers here.
Right.
Oh, yeah. 30 Ooh, yep. feathers. So if you see a tree, let me know so I can get some more wood. Oh, there we go. let's see here. These are little tree bushes, too. But we're in the desert, as you can tell, so it's a little harder to find trees. We're going to have to cross this river. Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
So why did you ask? Is that something that's dangerous, or?
It's not. Well, I mean, you could go under here and drown. So if you're not a good swimmer,
okay,
it might not work out for you.
I see.
I'm not really sure what Ramon's like in the water. I haven't seen him swim before.
Okay.
Zombies go in the water, like if you were being chased.
Yeah, yeah. The they can. And animals can run into the water. So if you're on the hot tail of a deer trying to kill it, it'll run into the water and try to get away from you.
I see.
And you move a little bit slower in there. Let's see.
Can you lure zombies into the water, and then does that like slow them down?
I suppose. Well, it slows you down as well.
Oh.
So
okay.
Sort of a double-edged sword there. If you go in there, you'll slow down. They'll slow down. Ooh, I just saw a trash bag in the middle of the desert. Is Ramon following me?
Yeah, I'm behind you. Don't worry about it.
All right.
Ramon's just not doing anything.
I'm getting my yucca plants. Ramon, yucca plants are important.
Am I the leader of this crew?
This is why he should just eat them.
Wow.
just get them out of the way. You have food for days.
Stream over. Ooh, yeah. Some iron.
Is it gonna be slowing me down?
Iron arrowheads. So these will be good when I've got a bunch of. Oh, I keep.
Trash bags are. We don't know what's in them, right? I mean, it could always be something random.
Yeah. It could be good. There could be nothing in it.
Just more moldy sandwiches.
But in general, I like to risk it and. Spend the time and look at each one, just in case. I'm just collecting feathers now because I don't really want to get a lot of arrows.
After you've tried collecting them, it'll tell you that, like, oh, because if you haven't seen it before, it'll say untouched.
Okay. Yeah.
So it kind of, okay. You won't be like, you won't get lost trying to check the same garbage can over and over
again. We're getting kind of close to this loot box. Let's see.
So speaking of time, obviously time management is pretty important in this game.
Yeah, yes. We're doing terrible.
Yeah.
So... You know, what do you recommend for people just like starting off this game?
So for starters, I would do the default settings. That sort of gives you ample time in the first 7 days to get your bearings straight, get the right amount of resources, and start figuring out a place to either call your base or to maybe even make your own base. So in here, in this building category, as you can see, you've got all the materials needed to make a house. So you could take a bunch of wood frames, create an outline. Start building up walls, levels, stairs, make a fortified door.
And you have to do that yourself?
Yep.
Okay.
Or, if you wanted, you could find a house that's been built and sort of reinforce that.
Yeah.
I mean, that one place that you
We could have taken that apartment. Yeah.
Yep, we could have. One thing to keep in mind when you're playing and figuring out a base is you want certain things to be near you. So I would be a little reluctant to make that apartment building my home base simply because there's not a lot of wood around here. I'm not finding much wood. So I like to build near where there's a lot of trees in the green biome. Another thing to keep in mind is you want to kind of be near a town because more loot spawns near towns. So you kind of want your base to be around where you can go into town and get some stuff. So out here in the desert, while it might seem appealing from a sort of isolationist perspective, yeah. Might not actually work. So here's the loot crate. So every 24 hours in the game, not in real time, in the game time, around noon, a plane will fly overhead, drop this crate, and it'll mark it on the map for you. So this thing always has good stuff. Okay, so this is great. So a flaming arrow schematic. So by reading this schematic, you learn how to craft flaming arrows. And with each of these schematics that you find, you'll learn how to make new weapons. So you want to read all the ones you find. A good place to find schematics is bookshelves. You'll find a lot of books and a lot of schematics in there where you can read them and sort of learn how to make things.
Nice.
So beaker, we'll take that. Antibiotics, we'll take that. 5 first aid kits, definitely need those. Painkillers. Rocket launcher stock. So that's just a piece of a rocket launcher. So once you... get all the parts for the rocket launcher, and you read the rocket launcher schematic, Suddenly you can create a rocket launcher.
That's how that works.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Well, so that's the other, like, big important part about towns is that they're one of the loots is, like, a book, and that's how you learn more recipes.
Yeah.
Yep. So also in this crate, there was a shotgun slug schematic.
Yeah.
So now, once we have all the pieces for a shotgun, create a shotgun, now we can actually make ammo for it.
All about the shotgun.
Yeah, shotgun's fun. And for zombies, there's not a much better gun than blasting them away with a shotgun.
Yeah.
So, it's a bit of a grind. You know, you've got to keep at it and keep reading everything you find because there could be a schematic inside a bag of trash. Mm-hmm. And you might look over it, but you should really. So let's see. We're more just exploring now. We should probably keep going up. Looks like we've covered this much. So we'll keep... Let's see if I'm going the right way. Yeah, let's just go up this way and see what we got.
Do it.
Oh, I'm seeing a town. Oh, yeah. Here's a town.
So is it possible to sabotage you know, somebody.
Like, you really just want him to kill me.
So you may have, sorry, Ramon.
So we're on a private server right now, and ostensibly we're friends, right? But we could go in here, and we could make each other not allies if we really wanted to survive in this world but not be together. Mm. Really, the one of the main appeals to this game is doing it with a friend. So mm-hmm. you're probably always going to have an ally.
Can you be friends... And then, like, maybe he took your moldy sandwich, and you're like, you know what? I'm done.
Yeah.
And then he'd want me to have the moldy sandwich if that was the case.
Yeah, so I suppose you could lie to him and tell him that the sandwich is going to be tasty.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
he takes it, gets sick, and dies.
Assuming he doesn't read.
Unfortunately, once you die, you do come back to life.
Oh, okay.
So it wouldn't... Oh, speaking of Ramon, we should craft beds.
That's like the sentence, the moldy sandwich is tasty.
So if you go into here and you create a bedroll... wherever you place your bedroll is where you will spawn if you die.
Should we take one of these houses that's like a temporary home?
Yeah.
Can the houses ever be infested with a bunch of these guys?
Oh, God. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh. I thought that was Ramon, but it was actually a zombie.
No, we are surrounded by zombies.
Oh, my God. I guess it is nighttime, right?
Okay. This moment we die.
Oh, that was a good shot. Okay.
Do they tend to travel in packs?
Yes.
Do you ever just have any lions wandering around?
There's sometimes... Oh, they're running. Oh, no.
Oh yeah. God. It's about that time.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, this is bad. Oh,
what?
Oh, no.
I've always wondered what it's like to, like, run really fast backwards while something is chasing you that's trying to kill you.
Oh, no.
Like, how does that work?
Oh, my God. They are running so fast.
Oh, man.
I'm just watching Ramon's screen. Oh, wow. He just lit somebody on fire.
Oh, missed shot.
But I'm not doing good. I'm, like, dying.
Does that slow them down at all? Oh. Nope.
There you go.
I'm going to die.
You got this, Ramon. Just light her on fire.
Does that kill them slowly over time, the fire?
I think so.
Yeah, oh, she's there. We go. Hit her.
I'm dying, though.
Oh, I got to place my bed in case I die.
Did you place your bed yet, Ramon?
No. All right. I took a Band-Aid. I'm good. All right. Did you end up placing your bed?
No, did you?
Maybe you should place them right next to each other. So.
Yeah. I'm scared.
So one of the... I'm going to just say this.
Yes.
As a person that has been involved in a lot of zombie fights? Media, I've played lots of games, watched lots of TV, movies that have zombies. You guys did a very terrible thing. And as soon as zombies...
Turn on the light?
No, as soon as zombies started coming, you guys split up. And now you don't know where any of you guys are at.
So I was saying,
you're going to die. What are you doing?
This guy's trying to sleep.
Yeah, I'm fine.
It's just like, all right.
Oh, I placed my bed. Okay. Whew. Oh, my goodness. I need to take a first aid.
You guys gotta find each other.
If only Ramon was near me.
I'm not telling you where I am. You have zombies on you. I don't want you here.
Oh, I'm infected now. Luckily, I have antibiotics.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can become a zombie? Is that what happens?
I think you just slowly die over time.
Okay.
So I'm going to go take my antibiotics that I found in the loot chest.
And that's
loot
the
case.
Only thing that's going to
cure you. And I could drop the antibiotics for Ramon to take. So if he finds something I need, if I've got like a bunch.
Zombie fun.
But you can't give him a pill that like...
No.
Kills him on purpose, right? Here's an antibiotic, is cyanide or something.
I'm not going to touch that one because I was already thinking about doing something like that. So these painkillers can also help restore your health, but they take away your hydration.
You're still moving.
I can't see anything anymore. Oh, that's another zombie.
Okay.
She's not even doing anything to you. She befriended you. Oh, she's eating you now. That's not her befriending you.
I can't see. Nothing's happening.
Yeah.
I'm fine. I'm just chilling. Nothing's happened.
There's a lot of blood on your screen.
Yeah. My screen's black, but nothing's happened.
You're very dead.
Yeah.
What? I'm fine.
So when you die, what happens? Do you lose?
You respawn.
Okay.
And you respawn... In a different place.
Oh, okay. So do you get to keep your gear, though,
that you found? So there are different tools. We have it set so that if you die, you drop what's on your tool belt, so what's on that hot bar.
Mm, okay.
But my actual inventory still has the other stuff.
Okay.
And so you respawned in a new location because you didn't set your bed, correct?
Let's not talk about
that. What? Just
you just had to rub it in.
So my stone axe just broke because I used it too much, so I craft a new one, and that'll be a stronger stone axe this time.
Nice.
So what you could do is if you had some downtime, you could craft a bunch of stone axes, level them up really quickly.
So every time you craft it, it becomes better.
Right, so now this is a level 2 stone axe. Right. So that's why it was also great that I found that 79 iron pickaxe.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm in this town all by myself.
Yeah, yep, you're going to be there for a while.
Let's see what's in this car. I think the good side is that we killed all the zombies in this town.
Yeah. So I can't show you guys because I'm not on the screen.
Schematic.
But when you die, you also, like, your max health goes down.
Yes.
Oh, really?
So you can see that. Well, you...
So me in the lower, so in the lower left, you can see the health. I have 99 maximum. So when you die, I think you lose, what, 10?
I'm down at 90.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So let's talk a little bit about leveling, since we were just touching on a little bit. How does that work in terms of how do you level up?
So
leveling up your items or your...
So the more you're doing stuff, so if you're mining a lot, or if you're chopping a lot of wood, if you're gathering a lot of stuff, you level up on those categories. And then over here, you can start to buy perks with the points that you get. So right now I have 0 points. But as you keep doing things, it rewards you with points, and you can level up that way. And then the more that you do certain things, the more that you'll level up. So if I kill a bunch of zombies with a bow and arrow, I start to get a better archery skills and stuff like that.
What about your health? How do we level that up?
Yep, so you can do that. So I've already leveled up a little bit with my stamina, or with my athleticism, but you can also come in here. And so, like, for run, forest, run, running uses 10% less stamina per rank. So you can buy those. You can earn those. So I'm breaking into this house right now and see what we got. Okay. Ooh, books. Yeah. Oh, nothing. Let me down. Okay. Got a little sink here. Anything in it? Nothing in the sink. This was somebody's house that just left me nothing. Empty bottles. You could use these empty glass jars to go to a river and gather water and then purify it by boiling it.
Mm.
I'm going to let it be for now. I don't really need to carry those around with me.
Can they follow you in the house, too, or is it kind of like anywhere inside is a sanctuary?
It depends. So I think... Oh.
They definitely can.
We got land
rats.
They
try and break down doors and stuff to get to you.
Yep. So if they were still in this town right now, if we hadn't killed them all... if I hadn't killed them all...
Wow.
then they would be following me into the house, definitely. But as you're going in, you know, you could set traps. You could set, you know, little things to try and help you out. So I'm just going to...
Yep.
Loot this house while I'm waiting for Ramon to come find
me. Yeah, I mean, this game's definitely a little sandboxy. If there is a point or so is to survive the seventh day, which on the seventh day, a massive wave of zombies kind of roams the world, and they'll come attack you, so they end up having to try and get through your defenses.
Okay, so there was not much in this house. Let's keep going. So in a lot of houses, you can find some pretty good stuff. It just really depends on your luck. You could go up to the attic or the basement. You could find a gun safe, which is, like, pretty much the ultimate find. So I'm going to go straight for the bookshelf, because that's where I'm going to learn stuff. More paper. Is that a suitcase? Yeah. Nothing in the suitcase. Ooh, more lead. Or more pipes. Stove. So there's secondary actions you can do to things as well. So if I have a wrench, if I find a wrench, you can use the wrench to sort of create parts off of that. So you could use that to get more pipe. You could do it to get springs, different things. But we don't have a wrench right now.
So meanwhile, I'm dying.
So now you're just chopping the stove.
Yeah, you could do that too. If you wanted to just destroy it like this, you could.
I see.
Yeah, it's becoming morning, finally.
Is that what the music represents?
Yep.
Yes.
So now we know it's 4 a.m. I have it set to 18-hour daylights right now.
Okay.
And all of that's customizable. So you could have it be darker for longer if you wanted. It makes me a little afraid to do it longer.
But
let's see. So we're already on day 3, which means we should really be thinking about base.
Yeah.
We could either take one of these houses, or we could.
I think that'll probably
think about creating.
It's probably a good idea.
Yeah,
that way we don't have to.
If you, when you get back to this town, I think. Ooh, goggles. So yeah, you can find things to wear. So I can go look at what my guy looks like right here. So this is him. He's not wearing much, but he's about to be wearing goggles.
It's what really matters.
Aviator goggles provide a little face protection and make you look really cool. Yeah. So I'm going to say yes to that every time.
So did I noticed, you know, there's a bunch of different characters you can pick.
Yep.
Does any of that matter? Is it just cosmetic or?
I think it's just cosmetic, right, Ramon? Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
How many characters can you choose?
The console version of the game has, I think, just what I was talking about. Got a wrench. Console has about 8 or 9 characters.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah, about that. So I'm going to take my can of chili and put it in here, and I'm going to get my wrench right here on my tool belt so I can demonstrate what I was talking about. So now I got my wrench out, and I can... There we go.
Nice.
So now I can... So on the right here, you can see it's adding, looks like lead pipes, and I just got some iron as well. If there's a toilet in this house, toilets are really good to do that, too. I would hope that this house has a toilet. Let's go take a look around. I really need to level up the stone axe.
I'm pretty sure Ramon is
Get there eventually.
Ramon, yeah, if you find anything...
Says, I'm still 0.8 kilometers away, so I'm getting there.
Yeah. If you find anything on the way...
He's not looking.
Yeah,
he's
don't.
Oh, there's a toilet. All right, so I'm going to go wrench this toilet and see if there's anything good in there.
That's a great that sounds sentence.
I'm going to go wrench this toilet.
Yeah, I need to go wrench this toilet. So I'll search it first. You always want to... Oh, so my stone axe just broke, so I'll craft a new one. Let's take a look in here. Ooh, bottled murky water. So would you drink water that you found out of a toilet?
Sometimes you need to, man.
Disgusting murky water, but it's the apocalypse. You can't be picky. No, boil out a campfire to purify it.
There you go.
So you could drink it. There's an option to drink it. I don't recommend it. It might give you a little bit of a stomach ache.
But yeah. You could give it to Ramon.
But I could give it to Ramon and slowly poison him. That's my ultimate goal. So I'm going to get in this
now
toilet.
Now, you guys have been separated for a while. Are you going to group up? I mean, is that something?
Shots fired.
Don't walk in there.
That was like the nicest way of saying that. It's like, Ramon, where are you?
So, yeah, I just did that to the toilet. Loving my wrench. Really glad I have a wrench now. What the wrench gives you is these short iron pipes, and one of the main things that you need to get yourself a forge is the short iron pipe. The forge is one of the most important things in the game to get.
Okay.
So it's used to smelt metals into tools and weapons. So most of the major things you need in the game, a lot of the major things you need in the game, you have to get the forge. So for the forge, you need stone, you need clay, you need bellows, and you need these short iron pipes. So to get bellows, here's the bellows, you need wood, animal hide, and again, short iron pipe. So if we got 20 animal hide, we could make the forge and some clay. And the animal hide comes from killing an animal and then taking its hide. And the killing an animal can be a little bit more tricky than you might think. One arrow doesn't just kill it.
And you have to go find them too.
And you got to go find them. So that's why it's nice to have a functional teammate. Able to. I was just saying, I wasn't saying that you're not a functional teammate. I was just saying that, you know, you guys could split up. one of you go find. What do you go find? Let's see. Let's see if there's anything good in this house. Where are you, Ramon? You're getting here.
Yeah, no,
you're
I'm close.
You're going to go find your backpack, too. Oh, yeah. So you drop your backpack when you die, but you can go grab the stuff that you dropped when you died.
That's good.
Yeah. Let's see here.
What's that pile of stuff over there?
Where was it? Which pile?
Oh, I saw something on the ground.
Oh, there's a trash can. Let's see if there's anything in the trash can.
I have to be getting close.
I'll take some empty jars, whatever. Uh-oh.
That didn't sound good.
So down in the lower left, you can see that I have 0 water in me. So I'm going to drink a little bit.
I was just thinking of it whenever you put out your torch. Does that attract zombies?
So flames can attract zombies in the nighttime if you have like a fire, if you build a campfire.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure torches do too.
Yeah. So this town's pretty residential. Not a lot of stores. A lot of times you'll find a gun shop in a town.
Ooh.
Or you'll find a police station, or you'll find a grocery store. And in those locations, as you guess, you know, they have similar items to what the store sold.
Yeah, I got my backpack.
So we'll take the nails, but I'm not going to take the rotting flesh. You can eat it, but you probably should not.
What should you do with rotting flesh?
It says you can eat it.
Okay.
Probably
is that like a desperation move then at that point?
Yeah, like if you were about to like straight up die.
Okay.
Oh, and here's an air conditioner that you can use with the wrench. Yeah, there we go. We got some pipe. Uh-oh. Did I just hear a zombie?
That's probably me.
Oh my god.
Paranoia.
Is that Ramon? No,
that's definitely not Ramon shuffling. It's like, Ramon, you sure are walking weird. What's going on here?
Did you get hit?
No.
There we go.
Nice.
And she had a moldy sandwich, but she had some bottled water.
Nice.
Look, we could be friends again.
Oh, my gosh. There he is. Wow.
Ramon.
Wow.
Ramon has returned.
Wrenching cars is also really helpful.
Hmm.
So which house are we making ours?
This
guy right here?
It'd be nice to have access to a roof.
Ooh.
So we could shoot. Let's get the tallest one in town.
Yeah, because you're probably safe once you're on a roof. I mean,
they can climb. So there's a thing called spider zombies.
Spider zombies?
Yeah.
Like two of the worst combinations.
Yeah. so that just said that I got 5 skill points. So I can go in here and I can spend those 5 points. So I'm going to rank up on running. Oh, I don't have that. That's 10 points, I see. For archery, I definitely want to level up there. So I'm going to use 2 of my points for that. Athletics, slow down stamina loss, and hold your breath longer. Yeah, I'm going to use the rest of my points for that. That way I can run for longer amounts of time.
Nice.
So these houses are all about the same. So which one seems like the best?
Tell me.
Maybe this is what you want to make your base.
I don't know.
Maybe this one's good.
There's a lot
the
of windows.
Paint job is nice on that. I like the
So, Ramon, I'm not sure what you're going to do. I am going to gather a bunch of wood, and I'm going to set up a bunch of wood spikes.
All right.
To surround our base and sort of protect us.
Which one's your base?
I'm going to pick this one here on the corner. You see it? You see me?
Yes.
This guy right here. I think he looks nice.
All right. I'm going to go find animals.
Yeah.
So you do you.
All right. I'm going to chop down some trees, and then I'm going to start crafting some spikes.
I never saw Ramon again.
Yeah. I'll come back to town once again tonight so you can protect me.
That is our motto here, actually. Is you do you.
Okay. So as I alluded to, you can set these traps. So these wood spikes are great protectors. Ooh, I can create 94 wood spikes right now.
That's a lot of wood spikes.
So I'm going to do that. I'm going to grab some more wood, too. Oh, no room in inventory. I can get rid of some...
You should make some chests for that.
I'll get rid of this
spot.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Now that we have a base...
See, I'm so smart.
Yeah, we're good. So now that we have a base, I could go create some wood spikes. Oh, and I'm also going to... Well, we didn't even search our base yet.
This is our base.
We picked out a place that we're in. So I'll go in there, and I'm going to put a campfire in there, too. Which might sound dangerous.
Yep.
But in this game, it's not dangerous.
Okay.
Don't worry.
All right.
Don't you worry.
I promise we'll be okay. Let's see. Did I get any wood for that? Do I have wood? I need to gather wood.
So you guys, obviously, you guys don't share inventory, right?
No. But so with these storage chests, that's effectively a way to share inventory.
Right.
So he could access my storage chest. So I'm going to go in here. I'm going to put this torch on the wall for now. Actually, I'm going to take it back.
That looks slightly dangerous.
Did I just break it?
You just punched your torch.
Oh, no, it's still... I want to make it a little bit lower. There we go. So now it's lit up in here. Oh, yeah, this is a good little bunker. All right, so I will create... a campfire, and I will create some wood storage chests. Where are they? So do you guys have any questions about this? Anyone in the chat? Anyone here? About or suggestions on how we should do this? I'm open to taking suggestions. Where is the wood chest?
I think you should have Ramon
there's the wood
not
chest.
Get into your base.
Wow.
And then I want to see him. I want to see him get destroyed.
Yeah,
I think you're playing this game wrong.
I'm all about sabotage.
Well, that's fair. All right, so we're crafting those spikes. Until those are done, I can't craft anything else. So I am going to start decorating our outside.
So these zombies will just like blindly run into these spikes.
Yep.
Okay.
Which is sort of fun to watch.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like a one and done deal.
No.
Oh no.
No, you want to layer these up.
Okay.
Because they still survive. But if you've got, oh, and they'll hurt you.
Yo, what's that thing? Oh, it's there's a care package.
Oh, you can get hurt by your own spikes.
You can get hurt by your own spikes.
Just like how you can back up into a cactus.
Correct. Yeah, unfortunately, the spikes hurt, and I'm not, well, I'll admit this, that I have literally died from my own.
And you can't push people in
my own. Right? You could potentially, like, push, like, if you had someone on your team named, like, Ramon, you could, like, push him into the spikes, I suppose.
I like it.
This is getting mean.
Within the 7 days when we're setting up these barricades, will they remain over the 7 days, or do they get broken down over time and you have to rebuild these?
They won't get broken. Well, I mean, the zombies do their best to destroy them. So whatever they are able to destroy will get destroyed. But it doesn't just, like, a hard reset, is that what you're asking?
Yeah, it's still they get broken down over time. And, but they,
so, like,
they
when the zombies run into these, they'll get all bloody and they'll weaken.
Okay.
And then... Oh, we have a back door to this place, too. So I'm going to want to reinforce that. So you can secondary action things like this. So I just reinforce the door with wood.
Nice.
And a little bit of scrap metal. So that'll make it harder for them to break through that door.
Man, I am not finding any animals.
Yeah, we are in the desert after all.
Surprise, yeah. Ramon is
I got
not
animals now.
I just hurt myself.
Yep.
So that's what I was talking
killing
about.
Himself.
That's what I was talking about.
Okay. Now, with the progression of the days, is it going to get significantly harder? Are more zombies going to spawn?
Yeah. So every seventh day is the horde. And like the 14-day horde, the 14th-day horde is stronger than the seventh-day horde.
Okay.
How long have you lasted?
What do you mean?
Like, you said... Like
me playing this game?
Yeah.
Personally?
Yeah.
Well, a lot of times I'll get to, like, maybe day 30 or something like that, and then I'll be like, I don't like how I did that. So yeah, I can go start. So I've probably played several games of this.
All right.
So now I can choose this, and I can go store things. So I'm going to store the paper, pipe, this, rocket launcher, leather.
Is there a point where you could just be so good at the game that you just won't die, or is dying inevitable?
Yeah, so I think there's an option, the hardcore option, where permadeath, basically. Okay. So you could do that if you really wanted a challenge. I would not suggest that for beginners.
Okay.
Because it's difficult. So I just freed up a bunch of space in my storage chest. Oh, I built two storage chests. Okay. I'll do one for Ramon.
Yeah.
He's so nice to me.
I know. He should have ate you like 2 hours ago.
Oh, boy.
Oh, is that? Oh, my gosh.
There's a guy just like crawling there. Can you like chain them up and then like just torture them for fun? Or...
Wow.
I'm just. I.
Now we know what kind of game you want.
Yeah. I just. Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I don't think I want to be your friend.
Is there a game where you can take Ramon and tie him up in torture?
All right then.
So I'm going to create a door because that guy just crawled into our place. So let's see here.
Okay, so you can barricade those as well.
Yeah, I'm going to create this door right here.
Is it still desert over by our house?
Yeah, it,
I'm not finding any animals. So I'm gonna go away from this desert.
Never saw Ramon again.
It's
So how does Ramon get into your place? Oh, it has a door.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought you were
so
where else do you go into?
So
a house,
he's like? Trying to break through this that door that I made yep. reinforced. So it's a good thing I reinforced that door.
Will he eventually be able to like struggle his way
oh,
through?
Oh, so
the
these
door?
Are all spots where zombies have attempted to get through, as you can tell.
And those barricades, do they have like health points or something?
Yep. Okay. So he crawled right through it somehow.
The guy's super determined. I mean, he's missing a leg.
You may want to kill him.
Yeah, he's breaking my... Oh, now he knows where I am at.
Yeah, let him come to the spikes.
There he goes.
Oh, he's dead.
So I got more spikes. So I'm going to finish doing the perimeter of our gorgeous base here.
We just had to get a base in the desert.
Yeah, all things being equal, I probably would have created a base.
Yeah, I think it was like the first thing you said when we started.
Yeah.
Like, we should get a
but
base
I sort
in
of,
the forest.
I sort of wanted to show some tips.
For the most part, aesthetically,
Oh, wow.
What's happening to you?
Oh, I got my first aid kit. So I almost just died. I think
you're
I just
still
kept
bleeding.
Did you, like, barricade yourself?
I think I just kept running into a... Oh, there was a little cactus right there.
It happens to me all the time.
Running into little cactus.
Yeah, just like,
Humble Park filled with cactuses.
The mean streets of Humble
That's
Park.
That's why they call them the mean streets.
Yep. All
right.
All right, where's my map?
I like the motion. It's like
throwing them out there.
Mm-hmm.
If you are super desperate and you've got a bunch of guys chasing you, one tactic you can do is run backwards and throw spikes. I've definitely done that.
Nice.
Yeah.
Too much success, I imagine.
Yeah. If you are the underground sort of builder.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm way too close.
What are you doing?
Yeah, you were like right on top of that. You were just like building stuff into you.
Right. Yeah.
This sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, this should work.
Don't do what I did, kids. You can build underground, so you can dig. It takes a while to dig a bunch, and you need some high-powered shovels to make it worth your while, but you can do that.
You have a lot of spikes.
Yeah, I made a lot. Somebody's got to help this
Somebody
town.
Has to protect us.
Yeah.
Shots fired.
Mine this
Those
wood.
Those weren't even shots.
Hey.
Now you're just being mean.
I'm leveling up.
Ramon.
Oh, Ramon.
I'm sorry.
No. I'm gonna hit this tree. I'm just gonna punch it. Also, I'm still can't find it. This is the biggest desert of all time.
Yeah, where are you?
It's starting to get dark too. Oh boy.
Uh-oh, I think I'm on spikes.
Oh boy.
Did I finish?
Going that way.
Oh, we're spiked right into the car. Okay, so I did a decent.
That's, yeah, I mean your front entrance doesn't have any spikes, but that's okay.
Yeah.
I'm glad all the sides are good though.
This front entrance could use a little bit of work. So I am going to destroy this shoddy little I'm gonna make some.
Why are you laughing at cactus? Am I saying it wrong?
I said cacti, and then I did, like,
cacti.
Is it, right? Cacti, right?
That's like the plural of cactus, right?
Yeah, it's yes. not cactuses.
Oh, who said cactuses?
Who did?
Somebody else said cactuses. I think
I probably did. I have my
Humble
Park
right?
language.
Can we confirm
Hi, Brandon.
This, right?
Is someone in the chat making fun of us?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are they saying?
What else is new?
They're probably just
this
making fun of Ramon.
Look at this place.
Oh, that looks like a
Ooh.
Legit place. Ramon, I think you should just abandon
did you just
this
find,
guy over
wait,
here.
Wait, did you just find our new base?
What is this? We you just put...
Oh, God.
I gotta go.
I mean, go inside the base.
Stop.
Dude, how far away are you? Oh, you're pretty close.
Yeah.
Okay, so this... Oh, so that would be a good place to raid to find some supplies.
So wait, all this time Ramon was right next to you?
Yeah, apparently.
I can't find
the
anything.
The desert was humongous.
He also acted like he had been traveling so long. And you can see on this map right here. Look how far he was.
Look at my map. It's fine. Look at
Oh, wow. Where you did travel quite
see?
A bit.
See?
You did one big surgery. All right. So now I got these wood frames. I'm gonna
Brandon, stop being mean.
So then I can reinforce these into actual blocks.
Do it.
So now our house is a little bit nicer.
Oh, you built some wood frames?
Yeah. So now we got our door.
Yeah. There's like... There's different types of frames too, right? There's like
you can do rebar, cobblestone, stuff like that. So there's our house. What else do we need to protect this house? Maybe we're gonna do a few more spikes.
Jeez,
No, Brandon.
Is that our Brandon?
Yeah, yeah, that's our Brandon.
Brandon.
What's he making fun of you?
Brandon.
Typical Ramon.
Nice. What's he saying about your Ramon?
No, this is someone else. Some random name. Dwarfin. No, it's John. It's my buddy John. At least I hope.
Your buddy?
If it's not my buddy John, then Dwarfin can be my new buddy. Maybe not John. I don't know.
So what else do we want to do for our house? We got some spikes here. I'm going to finish off this. Oh, I kind of want to.
You know what we failed at?
I kind of want this car to be away.
You know what we failed at?
What?
We didn't get any animal hides.
Yeah. Well,
you mean you didn't get any?
I mean, Ramon, I'm not looking to blame anyone here.
I'm going to go find zombies.
We sort of picked out who's doing what.
That's how you could do. You like shoot arrows at zombies and just run towards town.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. So you can't like hold the door, right? So it's like you go into the door and it's like, yeah, come on, and then you just shut it. Yeah, and you just shut it and slide.
I mean, I guess you could.
All right.
So I'm gonna leave a little gap for myself.
Right at the front steps.
There is no way we're not gonna die from those spikes. Those spikes are gonna kill us.
Actually, important question.
So if you hug the side here. Yeah, so if you're careful, Ramon, we can get through there. What is the...
chopping up wood.
What's he doing out there?
Ramon is just like...
I'm doing stuff.
Now, can you break down these barriers and get your resources back, or no?
You can get some of it,
you
but
can
not.
Break them down.
Like, you won't... You can't, like, recycle for exactly the same resources.
Okay.
So, do you get any?
Looks like we didn't get any.
No, you get any.
Wrecked.
That would... be someone saying hold the door. That would be Brandon. Brandon says hi.
Hello, Radox Gaming.
Radox Gaming.
Hold on.
No, we are not. We are. We just do the stream.
Wow, Ramon, way to give us credit.
I'm a KI developer.
Yeah,
I work on KI. You work on KI.
Yep,
I do too.
You do too.
Yep.
And Tommy is our community manager.
I'm going to put...
He doesn't care. He's so focused.
Yeah, well, he really wants us tracks.
So I just grabbed this chair.
You guys focus on the task here?
I just grabbed this chair, and I'm going to put it right here next to the fire.
Do it.
So in our home, you can now sit directly next to an indoor stone fire.
That's great.
I feel warm by the fire. So to start your fire, I guess I sort of glossed over that.
Man, hold on.
You got to use fuel.
Go ahead,
so I got some wood in there as fuel.
See, this is a lot.
I'm listening. I'm good. Ramon is just blindly staring at the fire.
Yeah, I mean, I got to keep warm, man.
Uh-oh.
What does that mean?
Oh, you know what that is.
What does that mean?
What's happening?
It's nighttime.
Okay.
I'm like, I could tell.
Have we really searched our
I don't think you guys have. I hope there's, like, just a bunch of zombies in there.
You hope that?
Yeah.
Yeah, we could spice
this up. Oh, more goggles. Ramon, if you need goggles, zombies. There's some in the nightstand in there.
I got my cowboy hat. I think I'm good.
Well,
wait, did I lose all my gear? No, I'm good. I'm good. I got my cowboy hat.
I'll take all that.
Yeah.
What's this right here? Does this lead to outside?
Oh, wait, I can wear goggles, too. Where are the goggles?
They're in the bedroom. Come back.
We have a bedroom?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Where's this bedroom?
Oh, yeah, bring the torch. Yeah.
Wait, is the bedroom in there?
Nope, it's in the room next to me. Yep, in there, in that nightstand right there.
I'm going to put my bed in here.
Yeah.
I mean, there's already a bed there.
No, oh, you're going to put your real bed in there. That's a good idea.
How do you equip this? There we go.
Ooh, I'm in the bathroom. All right. Oh, toilet? Yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh!
Pistol.
Who leaves a pistol in the toilet?
This is why you check every toilet in every building you go to.
It's like, I guess you're like... just got to poop, and you're like, man, there might be a zombie here. So I'm going to just put this inside my toilet.
So I have a pistol with several rounds in it. So, Ramon, if we get into some trouble here.
Can you shoot him?
I can't shoot him. <Okay. laughs>
Damn it. Hey, Ramon.
Me.
I have some meat for you.
I'm just trying to be cool and hang out in my little house.
Are there people in the chat that want to see Ramon dead, or is that more of just an us thing?
You can't see it.
looks like this door
needs to get reinforced. Man, you look legit. You look like you're in for some battle. Stream can't
Wait, what do I look like with my gun out?
Yeah, you're just like, oh, you're going to kill someone. Yeah, wow, yeah. Go away. That is terrifying.
Untouched bookcase. What are we doing? Yeah. Oh, schematic.
See?
Oh, crossbow schematic.
Nice.
So now we can read. Yeah, this is the schematic, or the crossbow is way better than the just regular bow.
I was going to say, you haven't crafted a crossbow yet, right? It's going to be the first crossbow.
Yeah, I can do that. You need some other stuff, though. I don't know if we're quite ready to craft that.
We still need those animal hides.
What was that music that just happened? Because it's already turned nighttime. So
I think that means it was midnight, and it changed what day it was.
Okay.
So is there... Let's say you're comfortable. So
for this, we need leather and forged iron to get the crossbow.
Yeah, we really need we got to find a forest tomorrow.
Yeah, we need
That's what we got to do.
So let's say that you guys think that you're good to go. You're not... You're like, you know what? I think I have enough, you know, barricades here at my base.
Yeah.
Can you just let the zombie horde come to you at that point and just, like, chill? Or
yeah, so basically... I mean, that's kind of like the... You know, it's like the... It's like tower defense kind of deal.
Okay.
Where, like, in tower defense, you can see them come through.
Yeah.
But I've... And I'm not good at this game.
Okay.
Clearly.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I've never been able to build a base where I don't have to do something.
Okay.
But, yeah, I mean, theoretically, that's part of the fun, right? It's to see them try and get to you.
Yeah, so, like, your best bet for a fun seven night is to sort of build a base that makes it very difficult for them to come into, get up on the roof, and just start popping them as you're up there. So, yeah, I need to get some sort of... Oh, yeah, iron-reinforced club. So this is better than the normal club. That's because I've collected some iron along the way. Ramon, so what were we going to find?
Oh, a forest. But do we want to wait till it's daylight for that?
I don't know.
You just want to do it.
Sam's scared.
Sam, you a little nervous?
No.
I'm a little nervous.
So can you skip days by, like, going to sleep or something?
No.
Okay.
Nope, you play it all.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Come on. We're not playing games to skip
them. I think you guys should go into the forest.
I played,
now.
Like, the really hard mode, and sometimes, it's going to turn light, so I just dig a hole and fall in and cover myself and then wait till daylight.
Really?
Yeah, because I can't fight crazy amounts of zombies.
Don't fight it. Okay, so we can explore a bit. Let's go get this loot box out here and see what we find along the way.
Wait, what are we... Oh, you want to get that loot box? Sure.
Yeah, let's get the loot box.
Don't lose each other.
Oh my gosh, I need to take a first aid kit.
Radex says things he likes about this game is you'll never run out of things to do.
Yes.
Yeah.
As someone who has played it for a decent amount of time, that's definitely true. And people on Twitch, you know, are playing and have, you know, 300 days.
Right.
That's crazy.
Like that. Yeah, oh yeah.
And you can stop your progress, save anytime.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah. And you can even do that in multiplayer. So me and Ramon could just stop whenever we wanted and
pick it back up.
Yeah, if you guys like watching us play this tonight, you know, we could always...
Yeah, I think at some point we're going to have to do a seventh-day stream.
Yeah.
Just watch us get destroyed. It might be a short stream, just because we'll get destroyed so fast.
Yeah.
But, you know.
We probably won't be able to get to the seventh night tonight.
No.
It won't really fit in with our schedule.
Yeah.
I mean, we can just pick it up.
But if there was some interest in maybe seeing what it looks like on the seventh night, we could definitely make that happen.
What happened?
I'm just heading straight for this.
I just walked over a cactus. Mm. Cactus are like my biggest enemies in this game.
I kind of want to use my gun.
Yeah, well, you go find animal. No, he can't shoot me. Stop.
Ooh, we're in decayed. Oh no, it's raining. Oh god. Well, that was easy.
Yeah, that's how that works.
I guess I'll go.
I've actually had that happen in Chicago before.
Yeah.
Like, one side of the street was actually raining, the other side wasn't. And I was like, that's weird. How did that happen?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
You gotta use your gun. Where are you?
I'm
save you.
You should run.
I'm gonna save you.
I'm running towards you. Ramon, help.
It's a good thing we can't see because it's dark.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Did you just run across me?
Yeah.
You did just run. Okay, where's...
Oh, God. I brought them.
Where are they?
Ramon's TV, is that for people that you can't see. Ramon's TV is so dark.
Yeah.
You can't see anything at all.
I shot him with an arrow, though.
Oh, there's a flaming guy running right towards you.
Why is there flaming dudes? What the... I'm already... See, now I'm
on fire.
Why am I on fire? Is there, like, a stop, drop, and roll?
But you can see now, which is great.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah, we should adjust your brightness.
Good job, me. No, this is how you play it.
Oh.
Oh, man. You just shot that
guy. Oh, they're like running. Look at that guy.
So he's a burn victim. And all he's carrying is some brass. All right.
Oh, man. That one, man. Like...
There's, like, a dude out here just trucking it.
Yeah. Is that a zombie?
So I used a lot. I used a lot of my bullets. I used a lot of my bullets for that, which I regret. I only have one.
That's kind
of
scary.
We still have to fight. Like, there's like still two more in front of us.
Okay, let's keep going. We should
probably.
I mean, he's pacing.
I have this iron reinforced club that is very strong, so I can go take out.
Oh, missed him.
That was a really far shot. Oh man,
there's a dude right next to you. Run.
Ha!
Oh, I missed.
That was terrible.
Oh, no. Oh, where my is God. It? Oh, my serious? God.
Ha! Oh, can they get hurt when they run into cactuses?
I don't know. Oh, I do have some of my spikes left. I can do that tactic.
I can't do that.
I can't do that.
I can't hit people with arrows. I'm going to hit them with this torch. All right, time for you to get some fire. Oh, no. Oh, it's daylight. Ah, yeah, you can't run at me anymore.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, no.
Yeah.
No, there's someone else on me. Oh, no, that's a cactus.
Give up, son. All right.
Yeah.
So he just died in a very stupid way. That was very stupid of him. And he had a moldy sandwich and some feathers.
Nice.
All right. So should we go look for that?
The forest?
That loot box now?
Oh, yeah. We're still on that. Okay. Yeah. Let's do it.
Those are by far the most valuable pickups.
So I see on your screen it says craft plant fiber cloth.
Oh, yeah. So here is like when you're starting the game, it gives you some sort of mini tasks to sort of give you an idea of what you're supposed to be doing.
I see. Okay.
So right now I could create pants, shirt, hood, shoes, gloves. Don't really feel like it right now.
Yeah.
Fine. If we're in the snow biome, you need to get clothes on.
Oh, really?
Because you will freeze.
Oh, interesting.
So that sort of teaches you how to build the clothes.
Tell me how do I get my health back.
Do you have a first aid kit on you?
No.
Okay, I could throw you some.
Wait, can I make a first aid kit?
Not yet, no.
So I can make some aloe cream. Does that give me health back?
Go look at it. First aid bandages. Oh, so you would make bandages with that. So you would need that and some cloth.
And will that give me?
And that will give you health, but I don't think you have any cloth right now. If you come over to me, I'll throw you a first aid kit right now.
All right.
Oh, boy. 30 minutes later, yeah, we're finally.
I need some blood bags.
Okay.
I got like 19 health. We'll see if I make it to you.
You got this, Ramon.
Yeah, I hear gunshots. Oh, man, it's those fire zombies again. I don't like the fire zombies.
They kind of have cute faces. Scary.
Say they have cute faces?
Yeah. Zombie looks kind of cute.
Okay.
Look at that face.
So this is the day that we find out that Isaac is a secret zombie. Let's see. Where are you? Oh, my gosh.
There's a zombie in front of you.
Oh, I'm freezing now. Hey.
Yeah, no, I would totally be the worst person to have at a zombie apocalypse, for sure.
You don't think it'd last that long?
No, it's because I would sabotage people so I can last longer.
So it's 24 degrees out here, which leads me to believe that I might want to wear some clothes.
I was going to say, so what does that do? If it's super cold, I mean, does that do anything to your health?
Yeah, so I'm going to start losing health, right?
Yep.
Okay.
So I'm going to create some gloves. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my goodness.
I mean, so you really have to think about every aspect of this game.
Yep. And the desert, you can overheat. But this rain right now is making us very... I'm experiencing hypothermia. So one thing I could do is create a campfire. Let's see if I can do that now. I'm going to craft a campfire.
You are hungry as well.
I can eat this lamb ration. I'm going to create this campfire.
We should be close to all the drops
here. So I'm out of bullets, so I can't really use the gun anymore. Oh my gosh, I'm on fire now. What
fire
the heck?
Oh boy.
Oh, don't die. Oh my god.
Don't die.
Oh dear god. Okay.
Oh no.
I'm so cold.
I'm dead. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die.
You got this, Ramon, just run.
Oh my god.
Nope. Run, Ramon. Run! Okay. Don't run into any cactuses.
Or fire stuff.
Or fire stuff.
Oh no. Mm. I'm trying to get wood so I can put it in my fire. Okay. Oh, man. I really wish I wasn't freezing right now so I could just run away.
Where are you? You're supposed to be protecting me with that pistol you got.
Pistol. Out of bullets. Okay. Now I'm warm. Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
All walked into the fire.
Yeah.
Idiots. Yes, they all walked into the fire.
That's pretty great.
That wasn't very smart of them. So now I'm feeling warm, and I just set everybody on fire. Wow. So that's one way to kill a bunch of zombies.
Yeah.
Keep walking in, yeah, there, idiots.
Yep.
I love that the guy, the burn victim, just made himself the burn victim again.
Oh, yeah. I'm freezing now.
Yeah, come by this fire.
Come on.
Come around the fire with me, man.
There's like six zombies here. Ramon is going to die.
No, I got this. How do you... There we go. Yeah, applied. Oh, finally.
Oh, I'm stunned. I'm stunned.
Also, I earned a trophy.
Good job, Christopher Columbus. All right. Here we go.
Oh, jeez. Why'd I come here? There's like 80 zombies here. What?
So I'm a little bit warm. Oh, my God. I'm 14 degrees. How is it 14 degrees out here? That's my question.
You should move.
I am freezing. This game keeps telling me that I'm cold. I'm experiencing hypothermia.
Should put more clothes on, man.
Yeah, I need to. I'm afraid to start crafting clothes and I'm around.
Or you can befriend the friendly zombie that is on fire, and then he would warm you up.
That's true.
Yeah.
All this checks out, and yeah. I'm out of arrows.
And I'm hungry.
We should leave this frozen tundra we came to. Just leave that care package alone, man. Yeah. Let's just get out of here.
Yeah, let's go back to house.
No, not the
hypothermia.
House.
Hypothermia.
We gotta go find the forest.
I was gonna say, are you guys in the forest right
I'm
now?
I'm dying.
I don't think this is the forest. Oh, no. You're gonna die.
I'm dying.
Yeah, you're gonna die.
I'm gonna die.
No, you're fine.
Yeah, you got a lot of health. You're fine.
I'm a young man. I'll be okay.
How many? Can you heal yourself while you're in this state, or no?
Yeah, I could try. Let's see.
Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, you're good.
You applied first aid. Still hungry.
Let's just head east. There has to be a forest somewhere.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. I would really like to get out of this biome.
Here we go. Oh no, this better not be a desert. Oh jeez.
Sam, is there? Oh, she's gone. Is there a beer on me?
There's not.
There's one more here. You want one?
Yes. No, there's
I
need it.
I don't know where it's at.
I need it at this point. Oh, no.
There's one in the fridge, Sam.
Can it be a trick beer that's not really a beer, and then Ramon can just, like, take the base for himself?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, no. Oh, no.
What do you do with this?
What?
How does this work?
Just pull it.
Ah.
There you go.
There you go, sir. Oh, I got this.
Okay, I'm almost to the desert. I'm going to warm up soon.
You should definitely trust me when I hand you this item.
I'm going to warm up soon. Oh.
Right, oh. I got to make more arrows.
Oh.
Boom. Arrows. Give me all your arrows.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I need more wood.
Oh, how did I survive that? How did we survive that?
We did it.
What's the chat have to say for themselves? Okay, I'm gonna eat this can of chili.
That you were pulling out a can of chili out of your pocket. Is that a zombie? Next
oh my
year?
God! Oh, yep. Oh no! Man, if only I had a teammate to help.
I'm right here, buddy.
He's watching you.
Hey, you did it. What? You don't need me.
Right, look at you.
We'll
just
kill this thing first. There, it's dead. That was all me.
I'm thirsty. I'm gonna drink some.
This guy has. Nothing. Okay. Is there more zombies coming? Dude, we gotta move.
We got a little pop-up message there. It says something about feedback detected. What is that?
Yeah, it was up there for a while.
Okay.
I can move it. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Just like that.
Nice.
Just like
so
that.
Do you need anything that you don't have?
No.
I have officially used all my first aid kits.
Oh,
so.
No.
The first aid bandage work. I got
good.
Me like 40
if
health
you...
Back.
You can also use pills to increase your health if you need.
Nice.
Oh, there's a zombie coming. Let's get out of here. So which direction should we go? I'm not going back to that forest. Let's keep going this way. Right. I'm not going back to that forest. Or that decaying fire.
Yeah.
That was messed up.
The cold decaying fire.
So we're at 10 a.m. on day 4.
Yep.
There's going to be some feathers in here, hopefully. Yes, 35. Dang.
Nice. Yeah, I'm also going to make myself some. All right, four. Oh, I need stone. That's what I need. I'm going to go up to that wood, that stone up there. I'll drag it to Sallow. Give me. Yeah.
Arrows. Oops.
Arrow. Oh, no. My axe.
Oh, I can only do two. Oh, I don't have any stone either. Where's all the stone?
Do, do, do.
I'm just intently watching. Don't mind me.
All right. Boom.
Oh, yeah. So I'm getting stone. I'm getting iron.
Yeah, you're getting all sorts of materials right now.
I'm really happy that I found this pickaxe.
Yeah.
That was one of the first things I found that was real.
Can
good.
Both of you guys like pickaxe a rock at the same time? Or?
Yeah, I think we could both do it at the same time. I mean, if Ramon was able to find himself a pickaxe, we could definitely do it.
Wow. Shots fired.
Shit on Ramon Day. That's cool.
It doesn't hurt my feelings at all.
Oh, I'm sorry. Ramon, I'm sorry.
No.
Do. I'm so sorry.
All right.
Okay, so are we still going this way? Okay, we're going this way. What's up here? Oh, there's a river.
Don't mind me making weird noises.
Yeah, what are you doing? Put that down.
Oh, weird noises.
Weirdo. All right. Find a forest yet? What? Oh, here we go. There's
y'all
green up ahead.
Haven't found a forest?
I think this is green. Yeah, here we go. Nope. It's just
where are
desert.
You? Oh, you're down there.
Yeah, I think wrong. I found the forest, yeah, guys. It's cactus.
There's like a gas station here.
There's
though.
Two loot boxes up in that hole.
Oh, and the frozen place?
Yeah. No, yeah, it was frozen, but it was like on fire as well.
Yeah. There's like a gas station up here.
Ooh, this would be good to loot. All right, I'm going to come find you.
Yeah, we got to figure out. We probably got like maybe 20 more minutes before we have to call it.
Yeah, it is currently
8.
8 p.m.
Ocho.
Ocho.
Yo hablo español.
So we're on day 4.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Not much has happened. We have gotten attacked a few times.
Uh-huh.
Which is not good.
Yeah,
I see.
That looks like a nicely reinforced place.
Oh, man, nurse. She could heal us.
Who?
There's a nurse right here.
So
that's the first nurse zombie I've seen.
Yeah, so the nurse zombies are
You should kill her. She's not dead.
He wanted a headshot her.
So they're a little more rare, but they...
I should let you search that.
What the heck? You searched it.
So it's
I'm going to let you search it. He takes all the materials.
You already searched it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so this does look like a nice... Wow, so this base does have... It's pretty fortified.
Yeah, I just chill there for a while.
Yo, what's this thing? Oh, it's a bridge.
Can you just chill on the top of that bridge area?
Yeah, you could. I've heard of people like wanting to start bases around a bridge because it's made out of such reinforced iron.
Yeah. Sure.
So you could definitely. Where's the door to this place? Oh God!
Oh, don't go into the barbed wire.
Okay. All right. Oh, it's a locked door.
You're luckily, have to punch it.
This pickaxe takes care of doors pretty nicely.
Now, would you only be able to break through that with a pickaxe?
No, you could actually punch it if you want. you can do anything in the game that
it
you
hurts
want
you though, right?
By punching. It does not hurt you. No. It should. It doesn't. So I'm
shows
in here now.
You how much I know.
I'm in here now. Ooh, beverage cooler. This could be good.
Yeah.
Nothing. Man. Stove?
Headshots all day out here.
Mm.
You
trash?
Don't even know. Is this guy dead?
Wow.
Yeah, dead.
Why did we break into this base?
Is that fun?
There's, what, did you make this campfire?
Yeah, that was me.
Oh, okay.
No.
Wait, what? Somebody else built a campfire.
Plot twist.
Somebody else built a campfire in here. Ooh, gunpowder. Yeah, I'll take it.
So you made a private game.
Yes.
Yeah.
And had you not made it private, and let's say I mysteriously disappeared, Okay. And then all of a sudden, there's just this random guy with a gun. Can he chase you and kill you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Is there?
Yeah, I think
there actually
so.
A friendly fire option? Or
yeah, I think if you're not allies.
It's automatic.
Oh my god.
Oh boy. So
somebody had a trap there.
Wow.
I'm going.
These zombies are smart.
Okay, so you got to get my backpack, Ramon.
No.
That was your first time, too.
There's
right?
a lot of good stuff in there.
That was the first time you died, right?
That was my first time dying. Shit. Not good. Oh, not good.
Oh, you did
all right. Oh, no.
Yeah, yeah. I respect it.
You never want to die.
Yeah.
No one wants to die. Spawn on my bed. So this is why you create a bed. Should have created a bed.
Wait, what's this trap?
In our new.
Am I going to die?
You're in a safe house.
I mean,
like, nothing is happening. Why are you going to die?
Because there's a trap in here somewhere.
Oh, the one that
the
Tom,
one that Tom
died in.
Yeah.
Just look for his bag.
What's happening?
As you were just saying, Tom, as you get further out and explore
oh my gosh,
areas,
we're really.
I mean, you definitely want to make your bed again, right? Set your bed.
Yeah.
We just made
my bed. Now I'll sleep in it.
Right? Just so that you respawn in that area so you don't get too
right.
far away,
when
right?
When you figure out where you want to be.
I found your backpack.
So that was a really smart thing to do. Whoever did this, the game, I guess, did this. But like, yep. They dug a hole, uh-huh. Put spikes on the ground, yeah. And it's just like, well, oh man,
that's very smart.
Yeah.
Whoever did this.
Yeah.
Okay.
This procedurally generated map is very smart.
No, that's definitely a tactic, is digging ditches, putting spikes in there, and then zombies fall into the spikes,
right,
and then they're just swimming in spikes.
or
just digging a ditch and hiding in it like Ramon.
You just got called a noob on chat.
I did?
Mm-hmm.
For doing what?
For dying to spikes like that.
Yeah.
Who dies to spikes?
Hey, that's fair. Hey, how many times have you died?
Once, and that was to a cactus. Much more impressive.
Wait, so are we going back to that place?
No, I'm coming back home.
We're going to be in our base.
This seems like a great home.
Uh-huh. Mm. Oh, do you want to leave? Do you want to make this our new home? We still have not found a forest. We are going to get destroyed on day 7.
Yeah, day 7's looking
good. Wait, why do you need a forest?
Because we still haven't gotten, like, we haven't been able to build the oven yet.
Yeah, we need the forge.
Leather.
What do you need for the shotgun at this point still?
First, we need a forge.
I'm just, like, coming straight there.
We need to find shotgun parts. We need to find shotgun parts.
Right.
It's like... We need to build a house.
Hey, did you get my bag?
Trying to build an oven.
Did you
You're
get
just
my
like,
bag?
How do we get a shotgun?
How do we get the shotgun?
Because there's a stone pick or the pickaxe in there. Was
yeah, no. Well, I mean, it wasn't there for some reason, but I did find this other stone pickaxe.
Okay.
So that one's mine now.
Okay, gotcha. That makes sense. So our base could look pretty good soon if we reinforce it enough. Man, I can't believe the chat called me a noob.
Yeah.
You're all like, yeah, we also agree with that.
Don't mind me.
How far away am I from you?
You're pretty close.
Oh, I'm pretty close.
I'm going to break into this house next door and see what we got.
Oh, yeah, we didn't move at all. We're terrible at this game.
This world is enormous.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, it's
been this one desert.
That's awesome.
Can't find any sweet animals to get their hides from.
Now, are there ever any zombies like in these houses?
Dude, there's like six zombies coming towards the house.
Are they ever inside though? When you break
yes.
into the house?
Okay. Yes. Yeah. Well, there
they can be.
Yeah, they can be. Mm-hmm. Depends on if it's boarded up or not. A lot of these boarded up places, they won't be able to have gotten into before. Sometimes. Oh, here we go.
So,
ooh, hunting rifle schematic.
So Totes just said that. You know, building a base on a bridge would be cool, but they collapse as soon as you walk on them.
Oh, no.
Oh, so that's a problem.
Wait, collapse as soon as you walk on it?
Apparently.
That
I kind of want to see that.
I've walked across bridges. Maybe.
Maybe there's certain types
Maybe they
of
mean, like, if the zombies destroy, like, the blocks at the base of the bridge, it might collapse. I've definitely been in structures where zombies attacked the base of it.
Are you at our base?
No, but I am going to steal this TV and put it in our base.
Okay. I like it.
Sorry to that neighbor.
I think it'll survive.
It says you are busy.
Who's busy?
The game just told you that you were busy.
Oh.
Yeah. What does that mean?
I don't know. Hmm. I didn't see that. So next to my chair and my fire, I am going to put up this nice little plasma I just got.
Oh!
I have not discovered a PS4 yet. But oh, who's going to be called the noob now?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look at that gorgeous TV. What would we say that is? 50 inches? That's nice.
Do, do, do.
Ugh, that's gorgeous.
Okay. You got your little fire and your TV. Man. Some Netflix.
Spawned yeah. on my bed.
I'm reinforcing this. Oh, yeah.
So, for you guys that did not see that, obviously.
Nothing happened.
Yeah, what
so
was it?
Ramon.
Ramon just died.
He, I saw Ramon laying dead on the ground. I was like, uh-huh. Oh, what happened? And there were spikes all around him.
Oh, so Ramon died in spikes.
Well, yeah, but they weren't like a trap spike. I just wasn't paying attention. Because I was reading the chat.
Huh.
That's how you justify it.
Mm.
So, apparently, if you.
That's real interesting. Apparently, if you what?
And walk across spikes, you just die.
Okay.
It's like a thing.
Yeah.
And now I can't see. Like, how do I get out of here? And maybe I should have changed the gamma on this TV or something.
Yeah, you definitely
should
have.
It's really dark. All right, here we go. I'm good. There's like a craft all thing.
Yeah, I didn't want to use all my wood, okay?
Fine.
Lay off me. All right.
Do-do-do.
Wait, does that mean you lost the backpack with all the good stuff in it? AKA my stuff.
Do-do-do. Oh, I found my bag.
Just watching you cut that tree. Mesmerized.
This base needs a lot of work.
I mean, you had a great base.
Yeah.
You died in it.
That base had clearly been set up by other people.
Yeah.
And it was a pretty good base.
What is Ramon doing?
I was getting that wood. It was important.
No, don't walk
into this. Not the spikes. You can't see him on this TV, man.
Is Ramon dying in our spikes?
I'm just going to go back inside. Nice and safe.
Did Ramon just
turn on this fireplace?
Get sunned by our own spikes.
He lost like half his health.
Turn on the fireplace, Ramon. Put some wood in there.
I'm dying.
You don't have shoes on yet, Tom.
No, I have no shoes. I can craft some.
You can't punch me. What are you doing?
I'm going to craft some.
Yeah, where's this chest? My like inventory is like super full.
Check it out. They're right by the TV.
Oh, they're right by the TV.
Yeah.
I'm going to use that one. Oh, they're locked, dude.
Oops, sorry.
Wow. You unlock them?
I can get in them. If you hit triangle, you can get in them, right?
No, dude, they're locked. I can't get in them.
They're sorry, locked what's to you. The, you what is to, like, the benefit of locking them, by the way?
It's so that other people can't get into your chest.
Oh, other people as yeah. the other people are playing with?
I'm going to leave it like that.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm just going to put gear in this.
We're on the same page now. I think you finally have crossed the dark side.
I trust you in a way, but then there's part of me that doesn't, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Not exactly sure what your motivations are.
I gave up on you. I'm just trying to find a cover to make my own. Here we go.
Oh, I'm going to take this TV now. And I'm going to put it right.
What?
I'm going to put
taking
this
a TV
on.
Away?
Wait, you have two TVs? Or wait.
Oh, there's a little TV.
That was a small TV.
It fell down. It was tiny. I'm going to take the TV and I'm going to put it up next to this one.
X.
There you go. That makes perfect sense.
This base is great.
Is that just like money?
I was just about to ask that. What is that on the ground? Is that a pile of money?
Go back to the door.
Yeah, like open the door again.
Open the door.
I'm also very curious. Well, yeah, what is that?
Blood, maybe, or just punch it. Yeah. Oh, it's liquid.
Yeah, it's the.
It's from whatever spilled there.
Yeah. See, someone said you just got to go up to that chest and then hold triangle. That'll give you a wheel.
Gotcha. Thanks a lot, chat.
Right?
I think it was the fire trying reflecting to help that us. Made it look like coins.
Okay, I'm going to...
Are you going to go unlock the
Oh, do you really need it?
No, I'm good now.
Do you really need it?
I'm putting,
just going to keep going over
putting it, I'm putting it all on this cupboard.
I want to get on the roof.
Why not?
I need to get on the roof. How would you guys suggest I get on the roof?
Can you build a ladder?
Ooh, now there's an idea.
That's a good idea.
Okay.
Can somebody climb the ladder, and then you push the ladder off, and then the person falls into the
such
spikes?
Such as Ramon.
That's awesome. You can do that only if they're named Ramon. That's okay. Like the only way you're able to...
Jeez.
I'm sorry, Ramon.
Reasons I stay inside my house. Oh, no.
I'll defend you.
Thank you.
Uh-oh.
It's night.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy, what are you doing? Oh, you're going up on the roof?
Can you fall down the ladder and get hurt? Or
yeah, I think depending on how high it gets.
Are you still waiting for that chest?
Nah.
He found a trash can. It's
maybe
okay.
You should take his TVs away.
I'm kind of like putting stuff in this cabinet. It's important. You got to do it.
I hope Tom just like loots the cabinet.
I don't know what Tom's doing. He's trying to get up on the roof.
I can't get up on the
failing miserably.
There you're
up there. What's that noise?
So this will be a good place. Maybe we could build, well, not right now, but we could build a little bit of an elevated sort of area to shoot down. Because I don't like being at an angle. I'd rather it be a flat base up top on this roof.
Yeah,
so
you can said do they that. Can climb. Can you barricade up top too?
Yeah, you could. Yeah, you'd need to. So basically the idea when the seventh day horde comes, hopefully this spike row is about 10 deep on all sides of you.
So you need that many.
That it definitely helps. You don't need them, but that helps a lot.
Yeah.
And then you'll be up here, and you'll sort of try. They're gonna go for your doors, and then they're gonna try and come up to get you.
Mm.
So if you were up here, you could shoot, hopefully guns, but like only one row, they're gonna go right through those spikes.
Right.
Yeah, that's just not nearly enough. And if you have a little ditch, they'll fall into a ditch, start swimming in the spikes,
die.
It's great. But yeah. 7 days to die.
Yeah. Yeah, we should probably call it around here.
Yeah.
And then we can try and get to the seventh day some other day.
Yeah, maybe we can do another stream with this and get to the seventh day.
Yeah, just continue.
What a horde is like.
Yeah, maybe one of our side streams or something like that.
Yeah, like a bonus 7 days to die stream.
Our bonus streams.
Bonus streams. I hope you guys enjoyed learning about 7 days to die.
Yeah.
I learned a lot.
It's really fun. It's one of those games that you could just play it forever, and you're always going to be building a better base and learning as you go. It's awesome.
Yeah, I just love how just everywhere you turn, you can do something
or
craft something.
Yeah, it's great like that. And the zombies progressively get harder. Mm. It seemed kind of hard for us, but like that was just like weak sauce. Like it gets really bad. Like
for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Cool, man.
So yeah,
you want to come inside so where it's nice and safe and warm with my torch?
Yeah,
yeah.
See
you guys
if I can.
Buy your beds
let's see if I can.
Yeah.
Right next.
I keep hearing something break.
Oh.
Oh boy.
Oh, that was
just jump off. Why not?
There we go.
Too bad there weren't spikes there. They just fall on top.
That'd been fitting.
All right,
so we're in.
Yeah. Oh boy, what's that?
What was that noise? Oh man. All
right. Well, I guess that's a stream, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it was fun. I think we're definitely doing a stream next week.
Yep.
Definitely.
Thursday, as always.
Yep.
And we're doing some fun games. Some
indie
games. No, I mean some indie games.
Wow. Multiplayer.
Yes. Where we'll be able to at least have all four of us.
Yeah. Playing. That should be fun.
Yeah.
I like it.
Cool.
All right.
Thank you guys for watching. As always, Thursday, 6:30 p.m. CST. We have a Twitter account, The Weekly Galaxy.
Mm-hmm.
You should follow that account for stream news.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'll put it on the Iron Galaxy account, but for the most up-to-date sort of stream news, The Weekly Galaxy is going to be your best bet. And thank you for coming on, Sam.
Yes.
Like it was great to have you as a guest.
Absolutely.
I'm sure we'll see you back here.
I would love it.
So, yeah.
Cool.
You guys got anything else?
No, I'm done. I want to watch the credits.
Right? Yeah, let's get the credits
rolling.
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks
for watching, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Bye, guys.
Peace.
See you.
Peace.
Bye. Don't.